Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we're doing the spider under the skin effect. I'll leave all the photos that I'm using linked below, but as usual, let's get started. We're going to start with our model layer here, the picture of our model. I've got my spider picture here that I've already cut out from the background using my selection brush. So we're going to grab our spider with a command C, bring it over to our model layer with a command V. Grab our move tool up here, bring our spider down and rotate it. And then we're gonna make the spider a little bit bigger. And we wanna place it so these claws are just coming on the edge of her eye here. Okay, that looks pretty good. On the background layer here, the background of the model, we're going to come over here to our liquify tool. Just going to press on our liquify tool and we're going to use this top one here, liquify push forward tool. Okay, I'm going to make my brush a tiny little bit bigger using my right and left bracket keys, and I'm going to zoom in just on the spider here and just where the claws come into the eye here, I'm just going to make a little bit of an indentation. Okay, we can hit apply and we can have a look at what that looks like, the two little indentations in the eye here. That looks pretty good. Okay, I'm going to zoom out again. On the spider layer here, I'm going to come up to select and I'm going to pick this one here, selection from layer, and that will put the selection back around the spider. So while we've got that selection around the spider, I'm going to duplicate that twice. I'm going to call the top spider layer black, hit enter. I'm going to call the next spider layer white and enter. And on this black spider layer here, I'm going to grab my paintbrush, I'm going to make sure that my opacity, my flow, and my hardness all at 100%. I'm going to hit D on the keyboard just to get those colors back to default colors, and then X to get my black. And with my black brush, I'm going to paint that spider black just in the selection there. Okay, I'm going to drop down to the spider white layer now and make my paintbrush white by hitting X on my keyboard. We can disable the black layer here and paint the spider white. Okay, once we've got the white spider and the black spider, let's bring both of these layers back again. We can now turn off this third spider layer, the original one. We can just turn that layer off for now. And on this black spider layer, we'll change the blend mode to soft light. We'll do the same for the white spider layer, change that to soft light as well. You're just left with this selection now. You can actually go ahead and hit escape or command D on your keyboard to get rid of those marching ants. Now, staying on the white layer here, I'm going to come over here to our move tool, and on that white layer, we're going to come down to our arrow keys on our keyboard. If we arrow down, we're going to get the emboss look, so the spider indented into the skin. But if we arrow up the other way, we're going to get a deboss look, which is a raised look on the spider. And you can go as much as you like to get as much detail as you like. I'm going to back it off a bit to about there, looking pretty good. Okay, what I'm going to do now is bring back my spider layer here, the whole spider, and I'm going to add a mask to that layer. And on that mask, I'm going to invert it with a command I. On that mask, I'm going to grab my paintbrush tool. I'm going to drop my opacity right down to about 15. Flow to about 15 as well. Nice and light. And the hardness, I'm going to drop to 0. I'm going to make my brush a bit bigger. I'm going to paint in white and I'm just going to bring back a little bit of detail on that spider under the skin, and that looks about perfect at the moment. Looking pretty good. Okay, on that mask layer still, and we'll bring the opacity and the flow all the way up to 100 now. Still on our brush, painting in white. Let's zoom in on the eye now, make our brush a bit bigger, and then we'll bring back the claws here into the eye or spider legs. This is where those little indentations come into play now. Just get that spider legs back into those indentations. Okay, looking pretty good. The other thing we can do is on the black layer of the spider here, drop our opacity and flow again pretty low to about 20. make sure we're painting in black. And where you see the shadow, you can just go over a little bit with the black if you want to, just to bring out those details a little bit more. Okay, once you're happy with that, we'll reduce the size a little bit. Going to group both of these layers together, the black and white spider layer now. Just going to hold my shift key down and click on both and then go Command G. And then on that group layer, I'm just going to add a Gaussian blur. Just going to make it about 3. Okay, I'm going to add another pixel layer up the top here. I'm going to change the blend mode to overlay. I'm going to pick a yellow color on my colors here, sort of like a nice yellow. On my brush, make sure my opacity and flow are up at 100% again. I'm going to zoom in on the eye here, and I'm just going to paint that yellow in around the eye. Make it look like the spider has added some poison in the eye there. Okay, let's zoom out a little bit. While I still got this yellow here, I might drop my opacity all the way down to about 10 and my flow all the way down to about 10 as well. Make my brush a little bit bigger. Might just put a little bit of yellow around the spider there, like the poison is going into her eye. Drop that down a little bit and we'll come over here to our web now and go Command C. Back to our picture with Command V. The web is something you can add if you want to. You don't really have to do the web, but I'll change the blend mode to screen. I'll bring the opacity down to about 50%. On the move tool here, I'm just going to arrange and flip that horizontally, position it about there. As I said, that's optional. You can either leave the web in or leave the web out. I think I will drop it a little bit more on the opacity there. And I might just do one more thing on this and add a curves adjustment layer. I'm going to bring it just above the group layer here and just bring it down a little bit and a little bit darker. About there looks pretty good. If you want to, like I said, if you come on to the white layer and arrow up a little bit more, that'll define it a little bit more. I'll leave that up to you purely taste-wise. But there we go, everybody. That is the spider under the skin effect using that emboss deboss effect with the white and black layer. I hope you found this tutorial interesting this week. If you did, if you like the tutorial, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll say to you, until next time, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.